Welcome to the lesson on graphs and tables. In this lesson, we will discuss the visual properties of graphs and tables and how to use them to solve problems and gather information to further make better decisions. A graph is a term for any sort of visual way to show a relationship between two or more things. Here's an example of a very easy graph that many of you may have seen before. It is called a pictograph. There are many different types of graphs to show us information or statistics. Well, statistics is a branch of math that involves the interpretation and presentation of data. So we take this information in this data, and we're able to organize it into a graph. Now with this graph, we are looking at the number of students with honors by homeroom. On the left side, we have the homeroom, the 11B, the 11A, and the key down at the bottom shows us that each star is worth 2 students. So we're able to look at what each homeroom has in terms of the students that have honors, and we can do that by counting the amount of stars attached to each homeroom. So because 10A has 5 stars, there are 10 students with honors in the homeroom of 10A. Now we take a look at a bar graph. With a bar graph, we get a different way to visually examine and present data. Now with bar graphs, we're presented with groups, in this case A, B, C, and D. And along the side, we are presented with information with some sort of data that ranges in the thousands. Bar graphs help us demonstrate a comparison in quantities. So let's take a look at a question on how we can pull the answer from this bar graph. How much more responses were there for D than B? So D has about 9,650 responses by looking at our graph, and B has about 9,450 responses. So when we do this subtraction, we're able to get that there was about a 200 response difference between group D and group B. And by repeating this process for other groups, we can better make conclusions about our data as a whole. Moving on to the pie graph, we are able to take information and interpret it and examine it as part of a whole. Pie graphs demonstrate portions of a whole. So imagine this whole circle is 100%, and we have what each of our categories, the other text or the text live in this case, what each of those categories represents. This category represents 6%, another represents 32%, and with these pie graphs, you can find concrete numbers by using ratios. So to take a look at our application question, in this case, we're wondering how much of a $500 budget would go to the category other text. So in order to solve this problem, I would take that budget of $500 and multiply it by the 6% that other text represents of the whole 100%. So 500 times 0.06 to better represent 6%. And after doing the multiplication, 500 times 0.06 would give me 30. So the budget amount that would go to other texts would be $30. Moving forward to line graphs, we're able to instead take a look at how information changes over time. That is that line graphs demonstrate a relationship of change between two variables or factors. In most cases, we are thinking about time. As time moves from left to right on the x-axis in this case, we're able to see how speed changes in meters per second on the y-axis. We're able to look at this information to then think about the question, as time increases, what is happening with speed? Well, there's nothing to calculate here, but think about it. As time is going forward, what's happening to speed? We can give the simple answer that the object is getting faster. It's important to consider that line graphs don't always have to be in seconds, and that sometimes line graphs can even span across years to show information over those times. Lastly, we're going to take a look at and examine tables. Now, tables might seem like the most complicated form of information presentation, but a table is organized in such a way to show us a large amount of information and how to present that data when two or more categories, in this case, are relevant. So we're thinking about this information and how it is best presented numerically because there are many categories to consider. Nonetheless, we can still take a look at all of this and focus in on what specifically we will need to look at each question. So, how many less apps are supported through iOS than Android? So let's pull out the information that we need. We need the apps that are supported for iOS. So supported for iOS is going to be 53. And we need to figure out how much less that is than the app supported through Android. Well, there are 102 apps supported through Android, and we performed a subtraction. 102 minus 53 gives me 49. There are 49 less apps supported through iOS, then Android. Now, as we think about graphs and tables at the end, we know that a wide variety of information will be presented to you in the forms of graphs or tables. And it's your ability to read and understand these tables that will help you make the best choices and possibly even saving money somewhere along the way.